To perform Valsalva maneuver, you simply need to close your nose and mouth and then try to exhale, and exactly this forceful exhalation against closed airways called Valsalva maneuver. And the central effect of this maneuver is increase in intrathoracic pressure. Valsalva maneuver has four phases that based on hemodynamic changes. Initially, forceful exhalation cause onset of straining that results in acute rise in intrathoracic pressure. This pressure is applied to pulmonary vessels and aorta. By pulmonary vessels, we understand pulmonary arteries and veins, and because they undergo the same changes, from now on, to simplify, we will mention them by collective terms, as pulmonary circulation or pulmonary vessels. In relation to pulmonary circulation, this rapid increase in intrathoracic pressure forces blood out from pulmonary vessels to left atrium, and this causes increase in systemic venous return. To explain this, there is heart, pulmonary veins, arteries and aorta. Blood is moving from right ventricle to pulmonary arteries, then to veins, and then to left atrium, left ventricle, and from left ventricle to aorta. And recall that, according to Ohm's law, flow is equal to pressure difference between two points in cardiovascular system divided on resistance. And in relation to flow from pulmonary circulation to left atrium, P1 is the pressure in pulmonary vessels, for example in pulmonary veins, and P2 is the pressure inside left atrium. So what happens is that this increase in intrathoracic pressure is applied to pulmonary vessels, and the more it compresses them, the higher becomes pressure inside them. So it increases P1, but at the same time pressure inside left atrium remains unchanged, thereby pressure difference increase, so flow from pulmonary vessels to left atrium increase. This means that the more volume of blood will come to left atrium. It's called increase in systemic venous return. The higher is systemic venous return, the more blood will come to left ventricle, so the higher will be left ventricular filling. And the higher is left ventricular filling, the more volume of blood is in left ventricle, and the more it presses left ventricular walls, so the higher become left ventricular distension. And according to Frank Starling's law, the higher is left ventricular distension, the higher is the force of left ventricular contraction. So the more blood left ventricle will push into aorta. It's called increase in stroke volume. So increase in systemic venous return cause increase in left ventricular filling. That increase left ventricular distension, and with increase in left ventricular distension, stroke volume increase. And recall that blood pressure is equal to cardiac output on systemic vascular resistance, and cardiac output is equal to stroke volume on heart rate. So with increase in stroke volume, cardiac output increase, and this results in increase in blood pressure. Also, increase in intrathoracic pressure compress aorta. The radius of aorta decreases, and this affects aortic resistance. To illustrate this, it's aorta, and when intrathoracic pressure compresses aorta, the radius of aorta decreases. And recall that resistance is inversely proportional to the force power of radius, and with a decrease in radius, aortic resistance increases. So aortic compression results in increase in aortic resistance, and this increased aortic resistance contributes to rise in blood pressure. This sequence of events that cause increase in blood pressure through increase in stroke volume and systemic vascular resistance called phase 1 of Valsalva maneuver. In the next phase, when blood is already forced from pulmonary circulation, increased intrathoracic pressure compresses pulmonary vessels. This compression causes increase in pulmonary vessel resistance that decreases systemic venous return. To illustrate this, it's heart. From previous stage, aorta remains compressed, and there is pulmonary arteries and veins. From right ventricle, blood is flowing to pulmonary arteries, then to veins, and then to left atrium. Increased intrathoracic pressure compresses pulmonary vessels. Their radius decreases. With decrease in radius, resistance increases, because resistance is inversely proportional to the force power of radius. So the smaller become radius of the vessel, the greater become resistance. And increase in pulmonary vessels resistance cause decrease in flow through pulmonary vessels, because flow is equal to pressure difference divided on resistance. So with increase in resistance, flow decreases. So this compression of pulmonary vessels causes impediment for right ventricle to push blood through pulmonary vessels to left atrium. So with increase in pulmonary vessels resistance, flow decreases, thereby systemic venous return decreases, and decrease in systemic venous return cause decrease in left ventricular filling. So distension of left ventricle decrease, and this results in decrease in stroke volume. So with decrease in systemic venous return, left ventricular filling decrease, the lesser become left ventricular distension, and this results in decreased stroke volume. And from formula of blood pressure, decrease in stroke volume cause decrease in cardiac output, and this results in decrease in blood pressure. Also, aorta at this moment still remains compressed, so there is no substantial changes compared to previous phase. This phase called second A phase and characterized by decrease in blood pressure due to decreased stroke volume. And in the next moment, this fallen blood pressure is sensed by baroreceptors and they react. First of all, they stimulate sympathetic nervous system. This causes vasoconstriction of blood vessels, thereby systemic vascular resistance increase. And also they stimulate sinoatrial node, and this causes increase in heart rate. So this compensatory response causes increase in blood pressure by increase in heart rate and increase in systemic vascular resistance. But cardiac output remains low because pulmonary vessels are compressed, so flow through them remains low. Left ventricular filling remains low and stroke volume thereby remains low because there is no increase in volume that can be pushed into aorta. This phase called second B phase and characterized by reflex increase in heart rate and increase in blood pressure. And then strain release, and at this moment intrathoracic pressure rapidly decreases. Now there is no additional force to compress pulmonary vessels and aorta, so they re-expand. To illustrate this, it's hot and all vessels are compressed, so it's second B stage, and when intrathoracic pressure rapidly decreases, pulmonary vessels re-expand. They reduce increase, so their resistance decreases and flow through them increases. So now there is no impediment for right ventricle to push blood through pulmonary circulation to left atrium. But the problem that this blood in right ventricle is still needs to be delivered to left atrium and then to left ventricle, and it takes time. And exactly this period of time when this increased blood volume due to increase in flow is going from right ventricle to left ventricle is phase 3 of Valsalva maneuver. So at phase 3, this increased blood volume is still incoming to left ventricle. Thereby left ventricular filling remains small as in previous phase. And also with decrease in intrathoracic pressure, aorta re-expand, reduce increase, aortic resistance decrease. But because left ventricular filling remains small, stroke volume remains also small, same as in previous phase. So when pulmonary vessels re-expand, their resistance decrease, so flow increase. But stroke volume remains low, same as in second phase. And also aorta re-expands, aortic resistance decrease, and from formula of blood pressure, if stroke volume remains the same and vascular resistance decrease, blood pressure decrease. So phase 3 characterized by sudden fallen blood pressure. And in the final stage, this increased blood volume comes into left ventricle and over distant left ventricular walls. This over-distension caused substantial increase in force of left ventricular contraction, so stroke volume substantially increased, and this from formula caused rapid increase in blood pressure. Baroreceptors on aortic arch sense this rise in pressure and provide vagal response that results in transient decrease in heart rate. Decrease in heart rate corrects cardiac output and returns pressure to baseline values. So phase 4 characterized by transient increase in blood pressure and decrease in heart rate, that then return to baseline values.